Okay, so hello everyone, and we have another tournament report, and it's nice to have another report. And yeah, sometimes they don't play like in Saturday, so they move into like a weekday, and we have some good days. Also, I forget to to make video about this tournament from China. And this is a Metacom report from Akira. You can check his blog. This is really good recap from him, because this Metacom breakdown is from a lot of tournament from Japan. And I think I will start from this. Yeah, this is Metacom report 7, and it's recap from 143 top deck, and from 19 tournament from Japan, China, Taiwan, and even from South Korea. So he add South Korea right now, but I think I think this is just he put it right now. I'm not sure he put the South Korea tournament too, but I think this is the first time I saw he put South Korea deck in here. But yes, as you can see, it is from 11 until 15 February. So I always make a update tournament report and this recap from Kakira. Tournament 23%. Purely 11 bestial and 3B, we have Castra, we have Ataman, Dragon Link, Exo, Runic, and Supreme. Pretty much you can play anything you want in OCC playing list right now. But even though it's look like the element still good, but it the game style right now is depend with your luck. And it's not like strong as before, but I believe this deck will get hit next ban list, because it's still good, but it need get ban list, let's say to limit all Izuzu card or something. And as you can see, 34 tier purely with 14 Bestial. Bestial have a lot of variant. They have like Sprite variant, Super Heavy variant, Punk, and they have Adventure, Grass, and 3P is still okay, I think. Have 12 3P, Castra is okay too, but it's not strong as before. 7 Adaman, 4 with Grass Super Heavy, 2 with the Vernusil or something, and this another variant, 5 Dragon Line, 5 Exo, 5 Runic, 5 Super Heavy, 3 Printed, Printed still okay too, 3 Coated Talker, 3 Sprite, 2 Flow, 2 PK, another thing is Adventure Synchron. I already share this combo before. Next we have Adventure VV, Blackwing, Chaos, pretty much you can play anything you want in here. And please remember this deck is not just random or something, because even though it's not much people play it, but they got top, so yeah. Next, for this, it's standard list. I don't want to talk about the lemon more, because it's like a standard list. Purely it depends with your style and depend with your local too. Because some people play Volcanic Engine, some people not. And for this list, he focus on tier mesa, because he play two-dimensional visor. And 3 Tegul, it's really strong. Even if you going first, you can discard it with purely quick play spell. And TT group because you can search it with this with it this one. You can search it with this one. And for conic fin when you going first, so let's say your pen like use your pen that cannot drop kaiju if you have this on the field. And when he try to expiate your noir, you still have this fin, so they need to naked or break this finish fin. Next bestial, this player use Cypher's gadget for engine and it's one card combo to summon this print. And let's next, yeah, nothing. Okay, I think I will move into this China tournament, and it is from 18 and 19 February. And wow, okay, so they had like 300 plus participants, which is really huge. And first place, it's purely, so I think it's only purely who got top 16, and the other thing is there, but it's nice to see different take cut top. And first place, purely he play Volcanic engine. This is for advantage. The good thing about this engine, then Tech World engine is if you use Tech World engine and you use that the true effect, you cannot use this spot if you use it. But if the good thing about this Volcanic engine is level 1, so you can use it for exit material. And he play a 3 dimensional officer, which is really strong, can steer. And bestial too, so as you can see, yeah, another, and it also really strong against super heavy, so pretty much this this dimensional officer alone really strong against tier pistol, triple adaman, dragonling, super heavy, so it's like it easy to kill 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mix up, and under rock tech is get by dimensional officer too. So this cat is really strong in main deck. And I think he played to this trap for consistency, cause sometimes one is enough, but sometimes you need another one. So that's why he played two. And for Rexha, it's standard. I don't know what this card is, but I think I need to research this first. But let me check it first. Exit. Rank 1, let's see. Okay. Wait, this one, right? Unaffected by undercut effect, and once per turn quick effect, you can detach two material, and this card cannot be destroyed by battle. Also, you take no battle damage. Okay, so I see. So I think he use this card for stall. I think if he like can is a break, you can summon this, but you need to detach two. So. Or maybe you can also summon this and detach two to summon Zeus maybe. I'm not sure about this, but this Lyricus is too much better if you want to stall, because it cannot destroy by battle or effect. I'm not sure about this card, because it's doing same thing. And also, and I think this Lyricus is too much better. Okay. I think he did another copy. Let's say he made something that banish your Lyricus. So you need, they need to banish unit number one. Yeah, I'm not sure about this, but I think this one is better. So let's move. Side-tech request. So he played this Santum and side for when you going first. Tasking, you can search this Santum with it. I think this is a field spell or not. Okay, so okay, this is interesting. He don't main take field spell, that's why he play this two trap. And I think the reason is this field spell is really bad when you going second, so you can use it when you going first. So that's why he have this in side deck. Yeah, I think it is field spell, right? Need to check it out first. Let's see. Purely. Yeah, it is a field spell. And yeah, the other thing is standard. I'm still not sure what this card is, because this card is doing the same thing with this Lyricus. Also, because he don't play Titi Crow, he choose to play Sylvan Princess Prot. So you can search any spell or trap. And this card is good if you don't play Titi Crow. I think it because he already have a Dimensional Officer, so you don't need Titi Crow. And it's because he have a Shifter inside deck, so that's why he... You don't need Titi Crow. Also, if you don't know how this shifter work in this deck, you can actually doing something like this. You can summon either of these two and exit summon with maybe in this Delicious. This is a best option maybe, and it will attach. And each time you activate the quick play purely, and you can attach to this. This plum, so it will not send to grave, and it will direct to attach into either of these three, and that's why he have the shifter. And if you play properly, you don't need to worry about it got finished or something, because the good thing about this purely it will yeah help you to attach your card each time you activate this purely quick play. And next tier standard is, I don't want to talk about this deck anymore maybe, because maybe most of you already know about this deck work, but actually it's complicated to explain this too. If you want to if you want to me to explain this, but I think I don't want to explain this anymore. Next Exorcister, and he only plays Teresa Kitama. But right now, people in Japan play like 2 or 3 Artama for 1 card combo. And let's see. Okay, so Trimudra and Galto, this is for the remains up. And it also level 4, and you can use it for exit material too. And I think this is interesting extra deck, because you play Lena, Selene, and Access. I think this is for OTK. Also, this help you against like a Baguska or something. Azil is like a staple in like or Dark Monster. Let's say you can also see this, saw this Azil in this purely too. Card is really good, and you don't need cost like a Nightmare Engine, because you need for Nightmare Engine you need to discard the card from hand, so that's why people play this Azil. And this is a Bestial Super Heavy, and this is like this is standard like Japan player. And he have Omega in here. It means you can cycle back your Omega with this Bestial. So it's like a minus 2 card open in hand. This combo is really good. And said, I like the idea of putting this float cap trap because yeah, it's continuous trap and you don't need to worry about this Cartesian set to brief. So you can still use your super heavy effect. Also rivalry, because I think the most card your super heavy is machine, so you can play under rivalry. Skill train, I think it's because we still have a big attack and you don't need to worry about activate effect or something. Okay, so Kurikara, it's interesting idea maybe. Yeah, in some matchup you can use this when you going second. I think this is like a nice attack. Eccentric shifter, what? So I think this is the first time I saw shifter in a super heavy deck. Okay, so this one is interesting. It also kill this deck, so that's why it's yeah, it's really weird. Even though you can banish this with your bestial maybe, and you just attack with your bestial, so it's like bestial piton with shifter. Another tier, I think that's it. This is from Road of the King block. And next, we move into this from Japan Bear, and this is super heavy FTK build. I already shared this combo in my YouTube channel, so you can check it out. The idea is just summon this level 12, and you can burn opponent with this super heavy Soulbreaker armor. And you need to decrease your defense of this super heavy with this DDD Maxwell. It's standard for FTK deck. Mourner help you to deal damage to opponent if that card is live. Okay, next we have Castira. Castira is still okay. It's not that good before, but it's still okay. Cause yeah, you need to play like Pathfinder, and you need to play in this Reshard. Because of this, you can play rank 4 monster. Like if you play Exiton, also right now some people play this Kaiju level 7. So even you draw this, you can normal this under this board, so this card is really good. Next purely, and okay, so he don't play volcanic or dark world engine, and also he play two field. Okay, so he play two field and only two my friend and two trap. And the other thing, he play only one pot, one tackle, one imper, he play one of it. And let's see. And he focus on purely monster, so he play a lot of multiple this. He play three plum and this happiness. He play two happiness. And Link, he only play Phoenix. And Ling Agent and Ling Guribu. Set Tritium Fist is like almost every purely list always have a Tritium Fist in main or set deck. Reaper, I think it is for mirror maps, which is interesting. And yeah, next. Next we have Sprite. Sprite that no is build is something like this. He play adventure engine. The reason put this adventure engine is like you can free summon token and summon under level 2 and summon sprint. And he also play this knife engine to summon herald. then I play Swapfrog. Swapfrog in OCC is semi limit. You can discard this water and center or this angler to start combo from there. Next, another purely. So he don't play S and play a troll, three troll instead. I think it's because S don't get your value. I think it's fine if your opponent try to max you, but troll is good in mirror match, but let's see what he write here. Okay. I'm not sure what he said. And okay, he played two field, three my friend. Okay, so interesting, he played two evenly and one dimensional barrier. I'm not sure what this this evenly man deck. But I think he just try it out. It's fine if you coin first, you open this, you can discard it with purely spell. Shot and extra, through trim face, two shifter. I already explain about this shifter in this deck. And the other thing is standard. Next tier, I think is standard list. Yeah, I think the difference is he play to talent. I think it's because of bestial. It's easy to resolve under like a mid take like a Neuer, purely I mean. But I think it is pretty much for bestial. You can easy to resolve this. And I think this is the player who always play in this Dragon Mat. If you don't know about this, it's like Merly, so it helps you to mill 3. Yeah, I think that's it. I think only in that he used this. It's really weird to see this card. Set an extra, he play 2 skill 10. People play this because of purely. And people also play 2 or 3 troll inside deck for purely. Next Exo Sister, they only play 2 Sakitama. Okay, so actually he have a good record. He have a 7-0 record. And the match is, I think it's all, yeah, he won all this the match up. Okay, it's look solid too. Next another Exo, and this time this player play 3 Aratama. Another tier. Yeah, I think nothing special in here. Next, super heavy. But I think it is not FTK version, it is like a standard version with Bestial. He also play Separate Stain to summon this natural exterior. He also play Omega. Omega is really have a good combo with this Bestial Synchro. And also play this Kurikara. Next we have this Synchrotic. Yeah, this is Synchrotic, but this time he focus on this Blazer Dragon, I think. Next, we have Sprite, another Sprite with standard list. Next, we have Branded with, yeah, he play one Golden Lord for like target, and you can free summon this because you have a lot of spell trap. Next Sprite, Sprite Adventure. Next is Dispurly with Volcanic Engine. With or without Volcanic Engine, it depend with you. Also, some player use Dark Volk Engine. Yeah, it depend with your local and your style. Next, we have First Space, Kiss Sprite. This is standard. Mantic and Sight is standard. Extra set is standard, and we have Flow and Exo Sister with 3 Aratama and 3 Sagetama. Next, another tier. Okay, so it is a 2v2 tournament, so this is first and second place. And next, we have third and fourth. Kastira, and yes, 60 cards. This Ataman and Valiant. This is unusual, but Valiant something sometimes cut top. The combo is still same with Fossil Trainer protected by this Elf. Next number tier. Next we have this Printed. He play a Tunip. Okay, so this Printed a bit different. Maybe I will call this check is Dogma because he don't play. Yeah, Printed Dogma maybe. He don't play Aluper. Okay, interesting. Okay, so this is another tier if you want to play a printed, and you can mix it with this Dogmatica. I see. Kastira standard list, I think. Yeah. Okay, so Necrophily actually really good in this meta because yeah, you can lock a tier, you can lock purely. Yeah, it only look like look like Lily, and you can look like this this Plum. He cannot target your their spell or trap in grave. I think it's okay against purely, but purely can easy take out this Necrophily. And it's good against 3-3, Bestial 2. I think it's pretty much it's good against any Undertake. Next we have Pendulum Magician. This is standard, the difference is you play Instant Fusion for this level 5 Pendulum Fusion. You play Prosperity, I think it's for consistency, but if you use this card, you can throw. But you cannot free throw by this Electrum, and if you already throw by Electrum, you cannot use spot. So you need to remember this. And one called, I think it won't cat S. Side play one nip to shifter three pistol. What is this? I think this is duster maybe. And to Dark Rule, to Evenly, set is standard, extra is standard too. And he has a good record too, I think. Yeah. Next, another Perlu mention, but this time it is from a Korean player. Wait, I think this is the same player from this. Yeah, I think this is the same report too, but with different angle maybe. Yeah, so okay. Next Runic, I think I don't want to talk more about this deck. Yeah, you don't need to. Yeah, this is like a standard Runic in OCG right now. He play Demise and 4 pot and a lot of Floodgate. And next, another Purely. And this time, this player play White Kaltu and Mutara, which is really strong against tier with Isisu. So let's say your Mutara and Kaltu got milled by Kalpeko Rakito, you can respawn opponent tier monster from their grave. Next, Exo Sister, and he have a bad record, 2-5, what? I think he red, but in here he have good record. Okay, so I think these two have different tournament maybe. And next, this is Wonderlist tournament. And first place is this Runic. And next, tier with Zephyros. Okay, so I'm not sure about this Zephyros in this deck. Yeah, it's like a free level 4. You can punch your screen and you can make level 4 from it. And if you focus on rank 4, I think it's better to use like number 60, because with number 60 you can summon card like Kaleido Heart. Next, another tier. And purely with Metal Fusion, I think he discard this and get a free draw from it. Okay, so this one is interesting because he have this two different pot inside deck. I think he use this when you going first, when he going first. Also have this S, one in main deck and one inside. Yeah, you don't need to open multiple of S. And next, another tier, I think. Yeah, this one is standard list, I think. So, take an extra. Next, Valiance. Runic. And Kiski, I think this Kiski is from tournament before. And this is a Dragon Link with 60 cards, and it is from a current player. And next, okay, so it is Castira. Okay. next tier. And yeah, I think I just want to show this because I think couple week ago someone asking about this ninja. And yeah, this ninja got top even though it's only 8 players. But okay, so I misclick. Yeah, you can use this for reference if you want to play this ninja deck. Yeah, I think that's it. We have a lot of lists. We have lists from China tournament, Japan, and recap from Road of the King. Yeah, I think that's it.